Alrighty guys, welcome to the stream. Welcome to another Sunday with ads. This will be ads 39, so we're definitely kicking through it. Let's get started. Let's do some intermission fun times. Show us the candy bar.
It's intermission time.
Yeah. Just chill, time isn't it? Some good vaporwave sort of stuff.
You're invited
and yeah,
to
we've got Cat with
stand.
Us early on, which is strange. It's a little unusual.
You'll find hot dogs,
just
juicy hamburgers, and mouth-watering delicious pizza. There are refreshing hot and cold beverages, ice cold cola, and orange drink. Goes great with an order
orange
of crispy
drink?
French fries.
If I put sauce on
wide selection of your
what is wrong
candies
with the
and other delicious oh, snacks. And there's always a fresh batch of hot buttered popcorn to go with the rest of the show. So visit the refreshment stand now during this 10-minute intermission and add to your enjoyment of the movie.
Every fucking time Cat's gotta make trouble.
And hope you'll come back often.
Yeah, my sentiments exactly. Well, those oh no, the egg rolls, the spring rolls.
So starts
the
dimmies
for a second. But yeah, still pretty fucked to save the world, I guess. We had our protests. Right last evening, sort of our point was more Indigenous people's death in custody. Apparently went pretty peaceful. Couple of people got pepper sprayed in Sydney, that's about it. But yeah, nothing too exciting on our front, not compared to the rest of the world.
Get the drift. We feature ice cold drinks at our concession.
Show starts in 8 minutes.
Yeah, Cat's here. Yeah, so more Japanese ads, more British ads. We're going to knock over the second half of the Chuck E. Cheese PSA. We've got another little PSA there. I even forgot which one I grabbed. And we're not doing Funhouse tonight. Funhouse is off. We are actually trying something a little different this time around. But, yeah, we'll reveal that when we get to it.
When you go out to a movie.
And,
show starts in
yeah,
7 minutes.
Trying to think what else I had planned. No, this week we're going to do some... I ran short on Australian ads, and I've since found a fresh batch, so we've got more Australian ads snuck in here.
Like you crave that corn when it's freshly bobbed, you gotta beat it to the box.
Oh, that's meant to be popcorn. Okay, that's abstract.
Make that
yeah.
Scene, get eyes for the coolest and dig some ice cream.
Oh, those delicious alto saxophones.
Get with it, man. Start scrolling down to the sweet stuff you're rolling, the best in town.
Not alto. Was it? Fuck. I played saxophone for like 5 years, I should know this. Baritone's the big curvy one, alto's what I played. I forgot what the thin one is. But yeah, it's still woodwind like a clarinet. Yeah, it could have technically been a clarinet, maybe. Going from the sound.
And the burgers are the biggest. Dad, that's a lot.
Yeah, I wonder when... Yeah, more Adult Swim shows should have fucking, spoof these.
Give us a treat.
Especially when you're combining, you know, abstract animation and, stoner humor, for the most part. Yeah, a bit more on Tim and Eric would be nice.
Frosty. Show starts in 6 minutes.
Help! Stuck in this basket.
Try our delicious pizza. It's ready and...
And oh, the audio keeps going on these ones.
Now.
But yeah, no, I definitely want to stay off, like, political talk. That's... I don't know, you come in here for escapism. Like, this is always going to be consumer garbage to sell stuff. But yeah, the effects of that definitely wear off when they're, you know, 30, 40, 50 years old. But yeah, No, we did mention last week, yeah, that would have been 1st of June when the restrictions for COVID eased.
Visit
we got like the,
enjoy our screen attractions
yeah,
in the
certain things
open,
not bars. Like certain restaurants did. Zoos and shit like that. But we're not at 100% free of COVID either. We just got 2 new cases in the last 24 hours. We cracked 7,000 cases a while ago. That's 7,200, and we're probably going to get a little bit more now that the protests sort of happened. Yeah, that was a point they made too. They're fining the organizers of the Melbourne one, because we're actually still technically under restrictions. You do get fined if you're in a gathering of more than 20 people, which definitely counted on Saturday. But,
hot, fresh French fries.
Should have, like, yeah. Fair enough, protests, do what you need to. Just don't break the law. You could have... None Zoom's popular. Anyway. Do it on fucking... Get 10,000 people in the same chat room in Zoom.
Hey, somebody's crazy. Papa goes the weasel. Everybody knows the weasel blows. But popcorn, she pops real good. I eat popcorn. Everybody eats popcorn.
No, break the laws. It's better that way. How are you, TP? Been a while.
Get yourself some now.
Hope you've still been busy on your... Yeah, hopefully you've done your thesis yet. You're still working on that. It'll still be good when that'll be over.
Fish sandwiches, golden brown and crunchy outside.
Fish sandwich.
And tender and juicy inside for a snack.
You've defended your thesis? Is that the right word to use?
Attention, please.
I was expecting completed.
$50 reward will be paid for information leading to the arrest and conviction of anyone caught stealing our speakers.
Hang on, people fucking stole them back in the day? Oh, well, yeah. Turn it in. There is no charge. I can recommend all that fun stuff. People are stupid.
When it comes to candy, I'll bet every young
man has a secret wish to own a candy store. Run it down for you as well. PSAs, we did like a Chuck E. Cheese one last week. We're finishing that. No Funhouse, we're trying something else. Australian ads. A heaven of delectable candy. Oh, that's the point of defending it, because you question in front of a chat room full of peers and teachers. Wow, okay, that's kind of terrifying. I haven't done public speaking for quite a while. Don't know how I'd manage it. Especially because, yeah, like most uni work I did was half-assed. Would have been umming and ahhing a fair bit. But yeah, I've been a lot easier. Yeah, using Zoom it'd be a lot easier, I imagine. Because you're in your comfort zone, you're at home. You can not wear, you can't, don't even have to wear pants. It's great. But yeah, no, I've been trying to do, like, yeah, other stuff to take my mind off things. I got, yeah, I used to have the album for it, Melody AM by Rocksop. I forgot how good that fucking album was.
Show starts just, in 2 minutes.
I seem to appreciate, like, chiller sort of electronic music as I get older. Let's follow this one. Someone mentioned the, I got onto this documentary years back where, there's this fella in the, yeah, Rocksop's chill. I double checked they are Norwegian as well. I knew they were Scandinavians. Yeah. Just check the Scandinavianness whenever you see it normally. But yeah, no, there were a few documentaries the BBC did about a fella in Alice Springs in Australia who started his own Red Kangaroo Sanctuary. And just, like, interesting guy, like, really simple-minded, like, called a brogger, that's a type of stork in Australia, because he's, like, 6'7". Lived out in a tin shed, no electricity, fucking gas stove, and just spent his time, like, hand-raising all these orphan kangaroo joys. Because, that's what usually happens if you
show starts in
hit a roo
minute.
And it, yeah, dies. It's usually got a living joey in the pouch, so he actually goes around, checks the roadkill, will take... They call them pinkies, the, like, super little baby ones, because they haven't grown hair yet. And if you put them in an incubator and they're, like, have a chance blowing through, they're good. They're like, yeah, and... Just interesting sort of thing, like, they have to sort of simulate the safety and comfort of a kangaroo pouch by putting them in pillowcases. So just, like, put each one in a pillowcase and sort of hang them or put them in a bag. take him around with him. Just, and there's been like three subsequent documentaries after that. So he finds a missus, and the last one from a couple of years back is he was starting a kangaroo hospital, or like a sanctuary but with a hospital, because the nearest one to Alice Springs is like 1500 k's away. And he's since done that, and that's currently running in Australia, so that's good. Yeah, it's just, yeah, like, I like the little documentaries like that where people just, you know, dedicate their lives to it, basically. It's just, yeah, it's something simple. And I certainly miss, you know, going out to the sticks in Australia, because you get, I love looking at the stars. Just, you go, you can't really do it in Melbourne because there's too much light pollution. You just can't see through, and it's fucking overcast this time of year for winter.
You know, in my day, we learned the three R's. Reading, writing, and rhythm.
Going off topic, there's Uncle Phil and the missus from Fresh Prince.
But today's schools need to teach.
We did that
skills.
Last week, yeah. We watched an episode of Funhouse, and the kids on the show were Laura and Urkel from Family Matters. Shit, I can't remember.
I keep forgetting who I'm talking to.
I can't remember. Yeah, I can barely ever remember the, yeah, just certain thingo cast changes. Because they did it with that Marlon Wayans one with the daughter or something. But yeah, fuck, I just lost my train of thought. I'll keep an eye on the volume. I'm kind of blocking Bernard here at the moment. Maybe if I, yeah, if I put the mouse out the right-hand side, I'll be okay. He's hogged, like, I put a towel down for him, like, so he'll stay up here, he'll keep warm. And, yeah, just takes up half my fucking mouse pad as well, the bastard. Rice pudding tonight. Just a towel. Come on. But yeah, we found a big pack of British ads a few weeks back, so we're chipping away at that. No, legit lost my train of thought before we saw Uncle Phil. He's got that effect. And I don't know that too, because he's the shredder from the 80s Ninja Turtles. And I think he was Raoul or something like that for the Fist of the North Star movie. He did get into voice acting after a little while. When you put the cat out tonight, actually, no, he started. I just realised he started in voice acting because Fresh Prince was early 90s and Ninja Turtles was mid 80s. But yeah, no, I've just been trying to find interesting stuff to watch and do as always. Oh, we've got that on the cards.
Had a nice holiday.
I got the emulator sorted out. I got onto German 985, who's mates with like Vinny and the other Vine Source guys. And he's pretty good. And I watched him do a 16-hour stream in of there's a PS2 game called Lifeline, where you could like survival horror, you control the girl with
access. Your flexible friend.
Bit of a sexy bell. I missed the sexy bell apparently. Dang it. Oh, and check my YouTube. There's a game you might like called Metamorphic Force.
With God as
a fucking,
oh,
I think you might like it.
Things
for
up after you. You're wasting money again.
And,
oh, Billy, I need some shopping.
Detergent and softener.
Bird.
So it's money, do I?
Oh yeah. I got kind of drained out on that one.
Clean and soft.
This bulb was expensive. You can hear me now though. Like, yeah. I'm getting spikes on the audio.
I'm coming at you and you get the electricity bill.
Yeah, awesome. Metamorphic Force, old Konami beat 'em up that I think you might like. It's on YouTube there at the moment. Kind of missed that ad.
Where do you think you're going?
But yeah, I've got the emulator set up to play Lifeline with the microphone, so I'll do that at some point. What else are we doing? Hollow Knight. Just got the Batman Arkham Knight. Yeah, just trying to keep out of trouble as always. Yeah, it's pretty good. Piggy bank savings account. £1 covers membership. For that, your child gets Woody. Then every 6 months. Gives me some inspiration. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. I'll kill for the dad bod the bear's got. I played as the bear for my run. Oh yeah, here we go. I actually, we got some of these. Well, goes back at McDonald's. Yeah, back big, when it was on. Bright, it's beautiful, but it can't last. Yeah, you just get a little pack of Lego with your Happy Meal. There are 15 or more pieces in every. And it was good. Like, my mum had a denim drawstring bag she made herself that just all our Lego got dumped in there. So if you ever wanted to play with it, you just undid the bag and it worked as a playmat as well. Love that thing. My cousins have it now. I think they're close to turning 18, so I might even take it back off them at some point.
And it's not a pretty sight. Even the simplest of tasks seem beyond his primitive brain. The hunter's
jokes are on backwards, I just realised.
Particularly if it helps him to wake up. Amazing, Neolithic to modern man in the time it takes to eat a bowl of Kellogg's Corn Flakes. Have you woken up to Kellogg's Corn Flakes?
I think we might have gotten that ad, but with an Australian voice dubbed over it.
I've come to fix the fridge.
It's over here.
Oh.
It's so hot.
Probably your thermostat.
Stop, stop. This blue movie is not ready yet. Where's this guy's moustache? Why is he actually fixing the fridge? You can't rush these things, guys. It's like making grog. It's brewed longer for a fuller taste. Now, let's try that again.
Hi, I've come to fix your fridge.
It's over here. It's so...
You hear the creaking of vinyl.
I'll just get my wrench out.
Nice.
Here we are. Can I take your coat?
Just a coffee.
Make yourself comfy.
If only everything was as quick as Rustlers.
You're so
hard. For fuck's sake.
Rustlers, not to tasty in 70 seconds.
Nah. I've tried microwave sausage rolls and pies before, but never burgers. All the burgers, just legit garbage. But yeah, I thought we could go vintage with their PSA safety thing today, with office etiquette from the 50s. Ooh, from Encyclopedia Britannica films. I need to get like a Mystery Science Theater overlay put under the bottom. It's just me and Bernard watching the movie. Maybe like me, Bernard, and Servo or something like that. It's got that vibe. I was just thinking about the one. One of my favourite short ones the other day. Mr. B Natural's pretty good.
I was lucky enough to have Mrs. Bell as my teacher. She taught us much more than typing.
Turn this up again.
She was teaching us to get along in the business world, and typing was only a part of it.
All right, Claire, stop typing, please.
Because if this is a film about office etiquette in the 50s, I want to see if they cover crop dusting at all. For an office job. Oh, this is... Yeah, shit, I can't remember that one.
It can be fun.
I'll find it down.
Or it can be hard. It all depends on the way you look at
it. Yeah, because I've got the full pack, and it usually just tells you what movie they're watching, not what the short is.
Well, don't forget
they usually
the golden
did
rule works there, just as it does anywhere else.
I think like second and third season,
treat
yeah, enough
to as you want to be.
Springy the Spring Sprite.
Here's how it applies to an office. First, of course, know your job. Enjoy it. But also enjoy the people that you're working with. Be considerate of them. And be considerate of your employer. Remember those simple rules of office etiquette.
Oh, like it's that fucking easy. Righto.
Now then, let's do skill building practice 8. Same margin. Begin typing when ready.
But yeah, I suppose they would have had it easier in the 50s because you wouldn't be able to hear anything over like an entire room of people typing. And the days when you needed like fantastic handwriting as well, like they... Otherwise, they beat you with a stick.
It wasn't until I got my first job that I really began to understand some of the things Miss Priscilla told us.
Don't get jealous of people. Can you use your fingers? Here, have a job that can get you a house. God, those days. Those days.
Thank you.
Oh, but you're on Fatty. Oh, you even got that on camera for once. Well done, you. Good on you, Fatty Bum.
I enjoyed being in her classes.
You did very well on your test.
Can you don't go back to sleep.
Monday morning. Oh, that would be wonderful, Mr.
That's some hassle when you're asleep.
We're a small organization, Miss Spencer. We find that getting along with people is pretty important. Do you think you can do that?
Oh, yes, I think I can.
Fine. We'll see you Monday. I believe your coat's in the outer office?
Yes.
Where are you going? Ah, all right. Well, I'm having my mouse pad back then.
And thank you.
Move the camera over to you.
I was a little worried about that first job. I guess everybody is. But Miss Purcell's advice kept running through my head.
First of all, know your work. Enjoy.
The days when everyone looked like they had a coat hanging stuck through their coat, too.
Be considerate of them. And be considerate of your employer. Remember those simple rules of office etiquette, and you'll get along in the business world.
Look! TP in your trunks!
OMN Kebab and RP Time. See you later.
Yeah, no worries, TP. Thank you, biddies. Enjoy RP and also kebabs. For sure.
Good morning. I'm Joan Spencer.
Oh, yes, Miss Spencer. We're expecting you. Miss Hamilton will be your supervisor, and she's on her way in now. Won't you have a seat?
Thank you.
This is all taking like 4 minutes.
Doing, Spencer?
Wow.
Ready to go to work?
I'm looking forward to it, Mr. Arnold.
Good morning.
Good morning, Miss Hamilton. This is Miss Spencer. She's the stenographer and file clerk who's starting this morning.
How do you do, Miss Spencer? I understand you're one of Miss Purcell's students.
Yes, I was graduated last semester.
I know her quite well. I'll show you where to leave your things, and then we can get to work.
All right.
It's the swishing that gets me. It's just a very different animal, isn't it?
This is Miss Spencer.
Miss Hamilton,
yeah, back when, yeah, everyone called, like, less experienced staff.
This will be your desk. This book contains some of our forms and procedures. Study it a while, and then we'll start you on your first assignment.
All right.
Oh, wow, she actually got a smile back. That's, yeah, this is fiction.
The girls
this is definitely
took me to
fiction.
Lunch that first day. It looked like it wouldn't be hard to follow part of Miss Purcell's advice. The part about enjoying the people you're working with.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Immediately get signed up to the social league. I like to strong arm people and that stuff.
I know your work was a little harder. I did a lot on my own those first few weeks. There was many.
Yeah, you're stuck with this 8 hours a day. You want to get stuck for another two or three? Yeah, no worries.
What a long time ago that was. It hardly seems possible now there was ever a time when I didn't know those terms.
And yeah, like I used to work in government service, and they are nuts about having morning teas for like every occasion. 10 o'clock, down tools. Go stuff your face with Reddit items. And sit around and talk crap for most of it, yeah.
Thank you, Miss Spencer. Well, Miss Spencer.
Yes, Mr. Kane?
This letter that you typed this morning, I believe there was a mistake here.
Oh?
It doesn't seem to make sense. I can't remember just what word I used there, but I don't think I could have said this.
Oh, yes, Mr. Kane, that's what you said. I have it right in my book.
Well, suppose I give you this paragraph over again.
Yes, sir.
Oh, she's shitting bricks, too.
In view of our current production schedule, we think it will be necessary to curtail our order, number 3256.
I had made a mistake, of course. It wasn't anything that Mr. Kane said. But I learned then to admit my mistakes gracefully instead of arguing about them or offering alibis.
Yeah, another good point, Mike.
I learned to ask when I wasn't sure instead of making a wild guess. And I learned not to resent criticism or to brood over it.
Mm-hmm. Another good point.
Since then, I've learned a lot of do's and don'ts about office etiquette by watching the others in the office.
Yeah. Because that's the other thing I found, too. A lot of it's not just down to the words, it's the intention. Like, yeah, government work, it's basically pat you on the back with one hand while holding a knife with the other sort of thing. Plenty of stuff like that. And it's just, it is genuinely petty. And it's just, yeah, it's one thing that, it's like schoolyard behaviour. Like, people just have not grown out of it and will do whatever they can to, you know, step on people's feet to get to the top. Yeah. And yeah, like, as if this guy's gonna get called and stuff like that. Don't you dare forget your right lovely little what? Didn't help to get the work done. Oh, just look busy and type shit out. Yeah, I've done that before. What was her name? Tookie? Spookie? Oh, she's like, yeah. Been off a lot of those to the BF, yeah.
And who do you think we ran into? Joe. I learned that personal telephone calls interfered with business.
Mary, this is the 50s. This is costing us like $100 a minute. Get off the phone.
No. You wouldn't think she was that kind, would you? Why, that little cat. I learned that it's only fair to plan your personal life so that you're always able to put in a full day's work.
Yeah, been there, buddy. Oof.
And that means working right up to the end of the day. And I learned that a date after work is no reason to break the rule about simple dress in the office. I learned, too, the importance of consideration for fellow workers. Thoughtlessness often makes
work... Oh, here comes the crop dusting. And spread that shit all over the room.
I learned to mind my own business by watching some who didn't.
Mr. Arnold wants to know if the insurance list is ready.
It will be in a moment. Wait for it, won't you?
Wait for it, won't you?
You know you shouldn't do that, Jimmy.
Do what?
But most of what I learned came from the people who really know their jobs. I learned the importance of neatness and organization in planning work.
Hear this bass line going.
There were times when I could help others.
Money! This is Taldor, eh?
All these things became even more important when I became Mr. Arnold's secretary. His work included public relations as well as personnel, so I had plenty to do. I had more contact with people outside the company, and I learned the importance of consideration for them, too, and especially courtesy on the telephone. Good morning, Mr. Arnold's office. He's in conference just now. This is his secretary. May I help you?
Oh, she moved up quick. Company. Yeah.
Oh, yes. Yes. No, that order was for 20,000. May we expect it next Tuesday? Oh, that'll be fine, Mr. Dahlmeier. Yes, goodbye.
Good morning. My name's Herbert Forbes. I have an appointment with Mr. Arnold.
Oh, yes, Mr. Forbes. Mr. Arnold will be with you in a moment. He asked that you fill out this application blank. You may sit at the table over there.
Yeah, they even go like... You sort of had to go above and beyond back then,
didn't
you?
Good morning, Mr. Arnold's office. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Fulton. He's in conference just now. May I have him call you back? Yes? Oh, yes.
Ooh, up well, to HR already. Okay.
As I look back on it now, it's surprising how often the things Miss Purcell talked about in class apply here in the office. You did very well on your test, Miss Collins, but I suppose that's only to be expected of one of Miss Purcell's students. Does she still make that little speech on office etiquette? Oh, yes.
Yeah, and you got to do the callback
first,
as well.
Of course, know your work. Enjoy it.
but also
I remember we watched a Japanese ad. It's like an anime one about like kids working at McDonald's that sort of covered all these bases in the space of like a minute instead of 10.
We'll see you in the morning then.
Yes.
A little bit surprising.
Fine.
That's weird they had like a film series, so I remember we had the encyclopedia.
To celebrate Sketchley's centenary, we'll give you £2 off your suede, leather, and sheepskin.
Sketchley, we know the meaning of cleaning.
Noodle Doodle came to town with lots of straight spaghetti. Twisted it around and round and round, now this is what you get.
I used to remember when they paid people to like come up with doodles like this. Oh, not doodles, I'm not thinking of doodles. Jingles, that's what I was trying to think.
Dexter's slobbing in the bath.
No, I'm cleaning the place up for you, my princess.
Yeah, it was the wrong slang of genitalia. It was meant to be, I was thinking of testicles, not the pins.
If you'd rather be relaxing than rinsing, try Flash Bathroom. It cleans the place easier than creams, without leaving that powdery residue. A doddle.
Wow.
Yeah, they all plug that, but most of the liquid ones just don't, aren't as strong.
Flash Bathroom does the hard work, so you don't have to.
Oh, gangsters? What?
The cops were putting the heat on the French Golden Delicious racket. So when the Crunch Bunch got word they were paying him a visit, Spats Fellini decided to turn over a new leaf.
They're doing like 1920s Prohibition stuff about apples.
But I just noticed something going on behind my back.
Such a pretty clever. Yep, not an idea.
During the hours of darkness, the...
Oh, fuck it.
Does your orange have anything added, or is it just juice?
No additives, no mess, no fuss, just juice.
Hey, and didn't it just say it was concentrate? They don't usually put stuff in there.
I don't want you to be no slave.
Yeah, I vaguely remember this one. Somehow.
To work all day. But I want you to be true. And I just want to make love to you.
Tomorrow. 11:30. Yeah, it makes a nice change from the gender reverse sort of ones. But yeah, we were about halfway on this one.
If you follow these steps, Chuck E. Cheese's will be the
place. Yeah. Hopefully, we'll see more of
magical
Frank.
Memories. Now that's hospitality. As a cast
yeah, get wrecked, old man.
This team, you make the hospitality feel for real. When the guest wins, we win. And you do, too.
And I was just thinking of that. Like, yeah, it's a good idea that you're... Yeah, I guess...
As you can see, guests
like,
come
if there's
Chuck
a kid
Cheese's
on their
for
own
many
you're
reasons.
Games with
Our
them,
marketing department does a tremendous job of trying to get our guests to come visit us. We sponsor various children's programs on PBS, run coupons in the Sunday paper, email us, and have some awesome commercials.
Yeah.
Now,
nice
it'll be up to you to make a difference to every guest who visits us. You make the difference with everything you do, no matter how small that may be. We promise the guest a great time, and it's our job to make sure that we make magic. Chuck E. Cheese and his friends Helen Henny, Jasper T. Jowls, Mr. Munch, and Pasquale entertain our guests 7 days a week. Your manager will let you know the specific hours of operation for your location. We are closed on Christmas Day company-wide and on Thanksgiving in the U.S. It takes everyone working together
oh, look at the
team to ensure that every guest has a magical experience.
That haircut.
Okay,
You've just seen a little about magic, hospitality, and how to handle a guest complaint. Now let's go to your flip chart. Your manager will go into much greater detail about these key items for you. So go ahead and pause the DVD.
And yeah, I forgot, well, we did have Funk Monk hasn't run up, but he did send me a video of like the animatronic animals like deteriorating or failing on stage and stuff like that. The deteriorated ones, yeah, obviously the inspiration for
next clip. And don't forget about Five Nights at Freddy's. At Chuck E. Cheese's, we believe that people.
And yeah, I legit want to play this cab. Really do.
Our people are treated fairly.
Firefighting rail shooter.
Employees have a great place to
Brave
work.
Fighters.
And free
okay.
Of any type of discrimination. Or
should
harassment.
Be able to find that. It doesn't look.
Any
too, might be on.
Misconduct will be subject to disciplinary action.
Like Naomi
or
fucking one of those.
So what
boss.
Is harassment? There are two.
Oh, here
of
we go.
Harassment.
Yeah. Yep.
Sexual harassment and hostile work environment. Sexual harassment is anything that makes you feel uncomfortable. One example would be quid pro quo, which is a Latin phrase meaning this for that. Some examples include basing salary or promotion upon the granting of a sexual favor
and they're probably
or
covering
continuing
the
a
key
personal
points
relationship. To merely imply to an employee that keeping their job is based upon granting of sexual favor
I mean,
or pursuing
yeah, if you've
a
got, like, the dirty old manager.
Or to state or imply that an employee's promotion in the company is related to the sex of that employee or the granting of a sexual favor or relationship. The second type of harassment is called hostile work environment, which is any type of conduct that unreasonably interferes with another employee's work or creates an intimidating, hostile, or offensive
Yeah, and they
work
probably, because you're dealing
Some
with...
Some examples include...
Well, that's the thing, they don't
lyrics,
really bring up...
bringing or displaying in the workplace any materials having
get
offensive
rid of this.
Content...
Got another one of these.
Telling jokes which
Got two of them,
racial,
okay, hang on.
Ethnic,
but three? Right, no,
discriminatory,
okay.
Or sexual Easy content.
Boy.
As a member of CEC, you should be aware that the issue of whether the conduct is considered harassment might depend on how that conduct is viewed by the employee who is subjected to it. This also applies even if the conduct might not have been intended as offensive.
Yes.
Chuck E. Cheese's anti-harassment policies apply not only to Chuck E. Cheese employees, but to our guests and vendors as well. Any StarCast member
I wonder if I can put
that he or she has been subjected
Actually,
to
no, yeah, I can look back on the stream and grab the account names and just report those ones.
And the names of the individuals involved to someone with the authority to intervene. A complaint of harassment or
But yeah, I was
going to
bring up, like in Australia, if you're working with children, you need a working with children check. So basically, they're just looking up, like an offshoot of a police check, they're checking up to make sure you haven't been charged with any sort of like sexual conduct against minors and stuff like that. I don't know if they have that in the US or not.
This means that no member of management is ever too busy to discuss any concerns that you have relating to your work environment. Any employee can report an incident of harassment or discrimination by contacting
Yeah, like if they kid
at 1-800
That's the other thing as well. Like if they're promoting this adviews.com thing, like
receipt of a complaint,
it's a URL. Like you should just be able to block
if the investigation
that URL
determines
if all
that an individual engaged in conduct in violation of Chuck E. Cheese's policy
or working towards getting it shut down.
Including the possibility of termination of the appropriate
That
party.
Said, I should see...
It's very important that you understand harassment
yeah,
and how to
yeah,
avoid a potential situation or resolve one may it occur. Remember that we have an open-door policy.
Yeah, there was somewhere in the U.S. I did see an Amazon warehouse on fire.
If you have any questions or concerns.
They're probably on damage control.
Every employee at Chuck E. Cheese has the right to come to work and do their job without being subject to harassment. Take a few minutes to review with your manager the discrimination and harassment.
But yeah, that's what I was trying to say as
well.
Like you'd need to be
policies and procedures. If you have any questions now,
your work conduct would have to be suitable
the next quiz. You can now
for children, so no swears around the kids or anything like that. Yeah, I'm not pausing. You're not my dad. And, hang on, I'm sorry. What? You can get beers at Chuck E. Cheese.
So. Did you learn anything about our policies?
No, I want to learn about the responsible service
Great.
Of alcohol.
Let's go to the next section, responsible alcohol service.
Yeah, let's do it.
As you know, we are a restaurant where almost half of our guests are adults, parents, grandparents, aunts, and uncles. Nearly all of them are here to eat food, and some choose to have beer or wine with their food. We do not promote, advertise, or suggestively sell alcohol in any way. nor do we permit any Chuck E. Cheese's employee to consume alcohol on the premise, whether or off the clock.
There's a few places.
Even
that
if
still
the employee is of legal age.
Like, yeah,
it's merely for
pub.
Those guests who choose to have it. The issue is
because I have seen
workplaces
that just stash
that
beers.
We serve it responsibly.
On the
work
site,
you come
just
in.
Crack them open
we
at the end
to
of the
workday.
We owe it to
our guests to have a great time in our restaurants. If they choose to have beer or wine, we must ensure that they don't consume too much and have a safe ride home.
Oh, and you're expecting
all,
like teenagers
to
enforce this shit
again
too?
Again and again.
Actually, no. If you're serving
first
the food,
off,
and beer, you probably need
the
to
legal
be
legal aspect
a certain
and
age.
Liabilities
hey, fuck, Mom,
of
how you
serving
doing?
Alcohol.
Yeah, we just got on the interesting shit with the Chuck E. Cheese one. Apparently they serve alcohol there. I wasn't aware of that.
Can be held liable for guest actions.
Yeah, because there's not really that much stopping. Like, I've seen my cousins used to do it. You leave a beer on the table unattended, they'll just be fucking straight in there.
This includes both criminal and civil liability.
No, that's good, man. That's good.
That means you can be sued
you
or arrested for
not
following the
not
laws.
Not Chuck E. Cheese, you.
It's just not worth it. It is illegal to serve the following type of people. Minors,
that's very
even
surprising.
If they are with their parents. Intoxicated
I suppose
individuals
if it's just beer or wine,
or known
it's
habitual
bloody,
alcoholics.
It's probably like
no
football stadiums and stuff. It's usually marked up by 200%. But that's the thing, like
serving age.
Yeah, like most of these places are run by teenagers and they're expected
to
deal with like
of legal age in your
adults who are intoxicated. That's a little bit scary.
Or serve alcohol. That means if you are under the age to serve, you cannot check IDs, pour it, or
so
serve
you'd obviously have to be over 21 to work.
In some states or provinces, you must be of legal age to even clear off cups containing beer while bussing a table. If you are not old enough, get someone who is. Legal drinking age. If you are a cashier of legal age to serve, or a manager, it is your responsibility to make sure that the guests.
Yeah, I looked that up too. So we've done a few PSAs about training videos about Hardee's. Apparently, so we've got Carl's Jr. in Australia, and they're apparently the same thing, same company.
Both the cashier and the manager
young adults,
serve time in jail, as well as pay a fine, and the company could lose their liquor license.
But yeah, is the legal drinking age in America still 21?
We serve it responsibly. To be sure guests are
I'm
old
not
enough,
sure
you'll
if they have changed that.
IDs
it's actually 18
no matter how
in
old they appear,
Australia.
And knowing which IDs are valid. A valid ID is one of the following. A valid driver's license with a picture. A state or province issued ID with the picture. Federal military ID card. A U.S. or foreign passport.
In many states, it is okay
to only accept your state's driver's license.
If you do accept out-of-state licenses, use an ID checking guide to ensure that they are valid. When looking to check the authenticity of the ID, have them remove it from their wallet. Look at the state seal, expiration date, and make sure the description matches the person. Do the math. Ensure they are of legal
if you're not sure how to do these things, practice
state
with
state
the
province.
Lovely game Papers,
Look
Please.
For fake or altered information.
Good game.
If you have any doubts, get a manager. Remember, you may serve only one alcoholic beverage per person per valid ID.
Yeah, that's fair
blood
as well.
Blood alcohol content, or BAC,
I have
is
done
the
that
amount of
part,
alcohol
like,
in someone's
give me
bloodstream.
A double.
If a person drinks
no,
faster
no,
than
two,
his or
two,
her body can
drinks.
Process the alcohol, it gets absorbed
into
the bloodstream and begins
Chuck E. Cheese
taking
ones
effect.
From the 90s?
In
nice.
Some states, point
yeah, I did watch the one you sent me with the
DWI.
The fails and
most
stuff when the animatronics failed
to
during concerts and fun stuff.
Or even 0.05. But how much does it take to reach those levels?
Some states it's 0.10.
Let's look at some facts about alcohol.
Okay.
One drink equals one
that's different too. Like that's at least
and
four
one
beers.
4 ounce glass of wine equals
Australia. It's
ounce of
standard across the board. 0.05. Otherwise, can't drive.
If one person has one large beer or the equivalent of two drinks in 1 hour, they may be as high as 0.05% of blood alcohol content. It takes the body about 1 hour to eliminate the serving of alcohol in one drink.
But,
but
like still,
that, it will begin to be absorbed
unless they have like security
and
guards enforcing this sort of stuff, like it's
here,
it seems unreasonable to have like teenagers or younger people
don't allow them to get intoxicated
enforcing, you know,
close.
Drunks
for
at fucking
example,
Chuck E. Cheese.
A 180-pound person who's had two large beers, which equals about four drinks, would be about 0.08% BAC. It's time to stop serving.
I can imagine the body weight
per hour.
level has kind of jumped up a bit in the last couple of years. Hostess,
it is imperative that everyone communicates and is aware of how much someone has had. Showroom attendants and birthday hostesses need to observe cups on the tables as they are interacting with their guests and notify their manager of potential.
But yeah, I'll have a look for next week. We'll see if we can find some more 90s ones.
That you not or, serve a person cheese. To the level close to intoxication. Remember, you could be
hey,
let's look at the warning signs.
I'm
first
cool.
stage, alcohol reduces inhibitions. The guests may be loud or overly friendly and annoy others around them. The second stage, alcohol impairs judgment. They may become argumentative or use foul language, especially if you stop serving them. If someone is at this point, immediately notify the manager. The third stage, alcohol slows down reaction time. Glassy eyes, slurred speech, increased consumption rate. The fourth
if
stage,
I was going to like an arcade to play,
spilling
like,
drinks,
I have played arcade
things,
games pissed
stumbling.
Before, but
the manager
if I'm trying for like a high score
off,
or something, I'm usually
sure they have
not
a safe
half-cut.
Ride home either with a sober guest in their party.
Bit tricky to play Donkey Kong when you're on the piss.
Remember, time is the only thing that helps someone sober up. At any time, if a guest becomes violent or abusive to a cast member or manager, they are no longer a guest, and it's time for them to leave. Management may call security or the police if they feel it is necessary.
Oh, they do have security there sometimes.
Don't touch or try to restrain a guest, especially if they've been drinking.
No, that's fair advice.
People are our greatest asset.
Yeah,
just remember,
the
Chuck E. Cheese is a fun place where families can enjoy their time together. We must act as a team to ensure that they have a great time here and get home safely. Go ahead and press pause to review the flip chart with your manager.
No,
and don't
right.
forget, you have an upcoming quiz.
We glanced at it. We're perfect. We're exemplary Chuck E. Cheese employees. Mainly because we've done nothing wrong and we're just starting out. Seeger's House of the Dead was fun. Did you guys get like the curtain that blocks the
so
screen from people
quiz?
Looking outside?
Again,
we
sure
got that.
Great. Now let's focus on safety and security.
We've been pretty strict on censorship over the years, and there are a few games like that in the arcades. Didn't do it with Mortal Kombat. Well, yeah, Mortal Kombat was kind of the reason for it.
CEC implemented a safety awareness program to help educate all cast members.
But yeah, like you'd usually see a few caps with like a actual classification rating on it.
Monthly safety poster, quarterly safety committee meetings, hazardous material information program, and a bloodborne
I've been a big fan. I've still got the typing of the dead. I did have like the old 98 Dreamcast one they did, and I've got like Overkill on Steam. We did play that at one point.
Unsafe working conditions.
I can't do it for extended periods. Like my wrists, like I can type really well and really fast, but my wrists start to play up after a while. Probably because I've been leaning like on the fucking desk all these years.
Each cast member has a personal responsibility in preventing accidents and observing safe practice rules and instructions that are related to your working environment.
Yep.
They include the following.
Put on your armor before you
safety into every
accost
job
any
procedure.
Drunk people.
Know and obey all safe practice rules. A monthly safety poster is
provided
in the to instruct you of safety warnings and procedures. Report all injuries to your manager, no matter how minor they
may appear
to be.
Had that on Dreamcast as well? Nice.
Caution fellow cast members when they perform unsafe acts. Ask questions when there is any doubt concerning safety. Report all unsafe conditions to your manager immediately.
That was the other thing as well. Like,
sponsored training and safety.
I don't know how legit it is,
ask
but one of the announcements for Sega's 60th birthday was they're doing like a keychain-sized Game Gear.
Guidelines of the CEC safety program.
Honestly, not what I was expecting. I was expecting something a bit more from Sega.
Action or termination. Remember,
I think ideally people want like a Dreamcast 2 or a Saturn Mini or something like that. I thought they were going that way.
As you get into the routine,
I thought it was Saturn related, because the
don't forget that
they did the ads and they've got the kid that's meant to be like the son of Segathar Sanshiro.
If you are leaving the building after
they're doing that or not,
ask someone to walk with you or make sure someone watches you reach your vehicle safely. Always have your keys ready to allow quick entry into your vehicle. If you notice any suspicious activity, report it to your manager. When you are arriving to work,
be
sure to lock your vehicle
bases,
and take care that valuables are not left on display as temptation for a potential thief. CEC is not responsible for damage or theft of your vehicle or valuables inside. Never open locked doors after closing. Once the front door is locked for closing, it can only be opened by a manager. Trash should never be taken out after dark. You may be providing a potential situation for a robbery to occur. As you continue your workday, be aware of potential hazards such as spills, objects on the floor, or children climbing on games. Also, be sure to only use equipment for which you've been properly trained. Some kitchen equipment requires you to be at least 18 years of age to operate or clean. Improper lifting can also result in injury. Remember to lift from the knees and ask for assistance if you need it. If you or anyone else is injured in the workplace, report it immediately, no matter how long you may think it is.
Kids have been breaking a lot of glass,
haven't
they? If you
have any questions concerning any of the CEC-approved chemicals, refer to the material safety data sheets or ask your manager.
If inclement weather, such as tornadoes, winter storms...
But yeah, like, I legit want to try this cab, the firefighting one. It looks cool.
In case of fire, ensure that you are aware of the location of all fire extinguishers and know how to use them if necessary. First of all, pull the pin, stand 8 to 10 feet away, aim at the base of the fire, and spray with a continuous back and forth motion.
What surprised me. You usually get separate instructions on manager.
There is also a sky tube evacuation plan located in the break area to educate you on the proper procedure of removing guests from the tube.
Review this to ensure we handle an
evacuation well. In any emergency situation, think clearly, act quickly.
Safety catches
execute
to get
the
them out of there quick. No, that's fair enough.
And follow your manager's instructions on keeping everyone
safe. That's smart.
Your
having an actual
evacuation
procedure
evacuation
for a kid's
and where
play
to
area.
Outside.
But no Dick Frank. I'm disappointed that there's no Dick Frank this time around.
We have a strict no-tolerance policy concerning drugs in the workplace. StarCast members and managers are strictly prohibited from using, possessing, selling, or offering any controlled substance, including narcotics, drugs, or alcohol while on duty, when conducting CEC business, and or while on CEC property. Cast members and managers are prohibited from reporting to work or from performing any work while impaired by or under the influence of a controlled substance. If you suspect another cast member of violating these guidelines, tell your manager immediately. Violations of this policy can result in discipline up to and including termination. Our policy concerning weapons and violence is very simple. Neither will be tolerated from an employee, vendor, or guest. Weapons, including guns, loaded or unloaded, knives, martial arts instruments, brass knuckles, threatening to the physical well-being and safety of our employees
are strictly prohibited on CEC premises.
While some state and local guidelines may permit concealed weapons to be carried by private citizens, exercises its right to prohibit all weapons on its premises.
Okay.
Any threats of violence, direct and indirect, should be reported to your manager. Report all suspicious individuals or activities and call 911 if you believe you or anyone else is in immediate danger. Avoid confrontation if a situation occurs, but defend yourself or guess if there is an
I remember watching Burn Notice sitting
and refer all inquiries from the media to your manager.
I know.
Remember, safety and security takes the efforts of everyone in the workplace.
Well, people just cheat, don't they? They just wear a fuck ton of rings.
At all
and get the,
times.
Yeah, like Rick James with the Unity one.
Today handbook or ask your manager.
We hope that none of these situations happen to you, but please be prepared to handle any crisis as it may occur. Be safe, have
fun. What are you squatting for?
Now, refer to the flip chart to review items in greater detail with your manager. There are quite a few, so it might take a little while to go over. Again, you will take a quiz after reviewing the flip chart. So
we have to remember everything we've just been told. That sucks. Another important one.
Wow, that was a lot of info, but those are things that you need to know in the workplace.
Remember that we want to provide a workplace.
Imagine calling your manager out on that. It's now, like, oh, you're allowed to wear that lanyard with all your company, your gold fucking pins really on it, but I'm not allowed to wear my Mr. T fucking necklace.
At Chuck E. Cheese's, we feel it's important that we look our best for our guests. Your manager will review the appearance standards for management as well as cast members using the flip chart. Go ahead and pause the DVD.
Yeah, I'm interested to know what the appearance standards are for
Did you notice that cell phones are not part of your uniform? Cell phones are not allowed while at work and should be kept in the office, your purse, or jacket. If there is an emergency and someone needs to contact you immediately, please have them contact the store directly.
Your appearance will make a lasting impression on
usually
each
they
guest
have lockers
that you
for
come
staff
in contact with. Therefore, the manager on duty will inspect your uniform daily to ensure that it meets or exceeds CEC standards in the areas of cleanliness, accuracy, and neatness. You should always be neat and clean in accordance with generally
accepted personal
hygiene
standards. I know why they
hired
this guy. He's basically got teeth like old Chuck E. Cheese there.
For security reasons, absolutely no changing will be allowed on CEC.
That's standard for managers. That's the evacuation procedure for certain managers. Like if the doors don't work, they should be able to chew their way through the wall.
Take pride in your uniform.
Like a beaver.
You never get a second chance to make a first impression with our guests.
Well, you're almost at the end. There are just a few more items to cover. The first is our menu. Take a few moments to go up to the front order area to look at the menu. It's a great time to stretch as well. Your manager will review it with you. Secondly, we need to go over some of our company benefits. Review your handbook, and if you have any questions, make sure you ask your
benefits
manager
in the videos?
Or district manager to explain it to you.
They'll be getting
lastly,
free tickets.
Let's talk about the training program.
I want
the key
that
to training is what you put
PS2,
into it.
PS2, you got
I'm sure
the,
you've heard the saying
the
that you only get out of it what you put into it. Ask a lot of questions. Get the info from your trainers. They are the pros, and they are here for you.
Oh, am I on? Oh.
Yeah, I want to see the menu.
I'm just getting ready for my next performance, and I can't... Let's see to find my favorite shirt. Oh!
Because I genuinely want to know how crazy they go with their pizzas,
but
too.
I know you've learned a lot about the company. You can contact your manager.
Because you get, like,
manager,
in, I know in Australia you get some very weird toppings as standard. Vegemite and cheese is a big one.
Now, do you remember the two rules here at Chuck E. Cheese?
Nutella and. No, that you get, like, Nutella
right.
and fruit for,
every
like, dessert pizzas at certain places.
And have fun while you work. It's all about making magic. So get out there and show them what you've got. I'm really glad you've joined my team.
And that's it. Alright, now we're gonna have to find some more of these, I think, Funk. These are gonna be. You needed this many. Oh, off camera contributors. Okay. Fair enough. What do we got next? Butch TV.
Butch McGuire!
Fellas, don't you long to be a woman? Don't you sometimes wish you wore high heels? Cause if you had a name like Florence.
What?
And you needed car insurance.
You'd get a bonds of different shields.
This is for the UK though. What? Pepperoni and cheese, that's it. Yeah, no, I gotta go with it. But meat lovers is standard for me. Maybe something a little bit exotic for the second pizza. Usually, you get a lot of Indian
like
curry
yogurt.
Pizzas like tandoori and chicken tikka.
Yeah, it's virtually fat-free.
And kebab pizzas. I love kebab pizzas where you can get them.
What? Because I'm getting all this pleasure, some poor so-and-so's getting a load of pain to balance it out.
Yeah.
I thought that was the Australian J.G. Wentworth. No, I think that was a legit UK ad. Because it said something about excluding Northern Ireland in the bottom part.
These cows live on green, green grass. The little cow asks, why is our butter so great?
Look at these fat fucks. Full of delicious milk. Are they getting them to dance? What? Yeah. Get in.
Because all do state that human grass makes butter great.
And I'm just, yeah, I was actually thinking about that today. I forgot which part of Ireland is independent of England. I think it's the Republic of Ireland. Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, there's Brian Brown. Famous Australian actor from, like, Cocktail and a couple other ones. Oh, yeah, he's still kicking around. Still doing a little bit of acting here and there.
When they say there's no rock and roll, they mean it.
Oh, it's implying it's a smooth ride. But I prefer Chuck Berry over classical for the most part. That's different. Yeah, yeah, because there's, there's reciprocal healthcare for, so, like, if you're an Australian citizen and you go to the UK, you can use the NHS. I'm just not sure how it goes between the UK and, England and Ireland. I think that's it. I think, yeah, the Republic would be separate. Yeah, I remember this one. And new sensitive skin. Oh, it was for, it's called Clearasil over here. And spanks the bottom of pimples. Smacks the bottom of pimples.
Right, come on, Big Dave. Let's get some tuck.
Turn this one up more.
Let's get this huge king pot noodle snack. It's not all for me. Big Dave's sharing it. Big Dave, it's true.
A whole king pot noodle. You fat bloater.
Sweets. Big Dave had some too.
Whatever. Come into bed.
What is he gonna get cucked by his imaginary friend? That's a bit. Cherry Coca Cola, Cherry Coke. It's new. The taste is gonna shake up your mind. No, the immigration's. No, I think, yeah. It's kind of weird. It's usually a citizenship thing. Like, so if a UK tourist comes here, they can use our healthcare services. But, like, it's limited. To public, yeah, it's public services, no private hospitals or anything like that. Because it's the NHS usually pays for everything. And here it's like a 60 to 80% discount on most things. But, yeah, I think ours is like, yeah, Italy, oh shit, I can't even remember them all. But yeah, it's like if you're a citizen of this country and you come here, you can use our services to a degree. And it's usually vice versa, but depends on the country what they offer. No, I've been liking these. Yeah, like, Yeah, no, I legit remember watching these when we went on holidays in the UK.
My son gave me these lights for Christmas. I'll sell them on eBay, as I'm
far too dull. Beige really isn't my colour, so I'm selling these and buying some trousers.
With a built-in camera. I'll sell my other phone to someone who'll
yelp and do somersaults. I bought it on eBay, but he says he now prefers
strap your stilettos. I got two pair, so I'll put one on eBay and see if anyone fancies.
My grandmother, she always gives me a jumper I won't wear. But someone
yeah, I fancy your grandmother, bud. I'm up for it. But yeah, I think... Yeah, we must have had more Australian ones near the end. We're getting that way.
Isn't it my mummy's major? It's a little sailing boat to bring your lunchbox. And, oh, wow. Well, it's a fireman's helmet.
Oh, because she's eating and, all the daff cakes. Yeah, okay.
Got a little igloo. Now, want mummy to make you a set of funny ears? What's it?
McVitie's mini Jaffa cakes. Deliciously self-centered.
Yeah, here we go. Here's some Australian ones. 90s as fuck, so I like it. A long day without it. You need time out with a friend. Doesn't matter where you are. Mackers can be very far. You can tell there's an You can tell them it's an Australian ad, because there's always the one guy with, like, the Cobra. The farm guy. It's when you're on your way. Yeah, oh, pull her off of that one.
Time,
Alright, no, the occasional thing of the wrong McDonald's statue moving is creeping me out. Always creepy when they do that. Yeah, I think I just found a big thing of McDonald's ads. Oh yeah, no, yeah, good luck getting through that in peak hour, mate. I think you're going to be spending, you know, good 20 minutes in your driving.
What about school, Dad?
Fuck.
Give yourself a break and get breakfast in a flash at McDonald's.
One outside of Walmart that's still around.
Now okay. In cinemas everywhere. Hercules. Ooh. Disney's legendary in-movie adventure has inspired the creation of McDonald's epic new burger.
Like, if nothing else, the casting of James Woods Colossus.
Layers of beef and melting cheese, topped with rashes of sizzling smoked bacon. McDonald's Colossus Burger. Yep. The stuff legends are made of.
Bacon. And that was big for, it's Max's Burger from the 90s. Something about the Australian KFC ads. Oh, is that the one they're touting as racist? I did see a few that got pulled.
Lassie's real meal goodness for real meal energy.
I couldn't really wrap my head around it.
Wheat germ in both Lassie varieties.
He needs a real meal, just like they do. That's why you give your dog Lassie.
It's real meal goodness.
That's some tiny fucking jet skis. Oh no, they're like hydrofoil ones. Nice.
I'm going oh, there is heaps for more. A Big Mac.
Yeah, we'll switch over next week, get some KFC ones. Because yeah, we've had the ones, I remember a lot of kids my age got the Looney Tunes character heads as like mugs. And like, yeah, everyone kept those for a very long time. Definitely got popular after, I think it was either for Space Jam or after Space Jam, I can't remember. I wouldn't mind finding some recent ones I like we had, a couple of years back we had Jeff Goldblum here plugging, Menu Log. They weren't too bad. Ethan's good with Jeff Goldblum.
Most girls today like to do things their own way. You can't tell them how to cook with rice or riso, because everyone's rice or riso is different.
It ain't what you do, it's the way that you do it. It ain't what you do, it's the way that you do it.
Oh, it's probably just like flavoring for rice or something.
Add your ingredients to these 8 great flavors. And when you start with rice or riso, the unique meal base, you can surprise even yourself.
Because I still use those, like the little flavor packets you mix in with something else to make sauce for your meat or... Yeah, did look a bit... Yeah. And that's not something you throw on the table too, like the one with like the rice in the middle and an entire line of like prawns around the side of it. Yeah, unless you live next to the ocean, yeah. Seafood's pretty expensive here. You blow your top next time you know just what to do. But I'll fix my car just like their own and treat me like a lady do. That's why at Ampel need you more than self-petrol. The things the others lack. At Ampel need you more than self-petrol. I remember when Ampel was around, they never used to do shit like this. And that guy is clearly not a mechanic. He's not covered in oil like most of them.
M&M's milk chocolates. Delicious full cream milk chocolate. Covered with a crisp, colourful shell. And now a new M&M's. M&M's milk chocolate with peanuts. Whole fresh roasted peanuts smothered in milk chocolate, then covered
oh
with
my
a
God,
crisp,
it's with
colourful
peanut
M&M's
shell. New.
M&M's milk Holy chocolates shit. And milk chocolate with peanuts. The milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
Oh, it's SO for us. Okay. Oh, no subs for the Japanese ads. That sucks. Oh, we're on animated though. Okay.
Good news! Minami Alps no yogurina. Reito dekiru tte yo. Tamaran yo.
Who the fuck goes home for like water?
Dore ni shiyou?
It's terrible. Oh, Baskin Robbins, eh? Okay.
Iba, double wo tarumu to poito tsuite kuru.
I'm hoping this one is all food. We have more food than last week. But yeah, we'll still plug Japan thing, David YouTube channel. I'm getting all these from. Yeah. And I'm hanging, I want to see the guy who hosts. Hang on, turn this down again. Yeah, I'm looking out for ones with the host of Gaki no Tsukai, Matsumoto. Because I read up on him and I didn't realize he was a film director. We had a show here on SBS, called Big Man Japan, that I actually quite liked, and he was apparently it was his first movie that he directed. It was a funny one too. It was like, there was a guy who could like turn like kaiju size and fight like alien kaiju, but he's sort of gets disillusioned with it. Like, it's sort of like a mockumentary about him. And he sort of fucked up a few times. He's like, has to wear all like corporate sponsorship over his uniform. It was an interesting movie. Some like legit funny bits in it too. I love that. Still love when they do that. Ever since there was that Samurai Champloo episode where they played the baseball game against like fucking the guy that came over, Matthew Perry, Commodore Perry, one of the first Americans that was trading with Japan. Yeah, I feel it'd be Dragon Quest. Yeah, it's sad I can pick them by just the costume sound. Oh, right there. I'll try Japanese curry at some point. I've heard, like, they actually chuck in, one of the flavors they chuck in is dark chocolate of all things.
Come on, Asu Jet.
Oh, it's Insect Pro. Okay. Was it called Ass Jet? Ooh. Oh, is that like, alcoholic sorbets, or just crushed ice?
Malibu Frozen Cocktail.
Oh, Malibu, yeah. They just showed it was Malibu. Yeah, I'm not a fan of white rum, I like dark glitter.
Yakiniku bibimba.
Bibitte no kai?
Spicy
world.
Motto motto.
Ice no mi.
And yeah, I did see one of the videos on the list was just all this chick. I need to research her, because yeah, she seems to rock up in a lot of these ads. I'm presuming, yeah, she had like one name, so I'm presuming she's like an idol or something.
I
like Onigiri, but I don't think I can have an instant one. And I have tried making it myself. It's quite hard. Like, yeah, getting the shape right If it, do, no, getting the rice to stick itself. I thought the brass broke down, yeah. Oh yeah, we've seen this one. And the cat's back. And yeah, these keep bloody volume keeps changing on these. Yeah, I can't remember if I mentioned it last week. I watched through all of Shokugeki no Soma. And I really want to try making some of the recipes in it. Old Japanese town where they're talking French. Right. Yeah. Classic game. Yeah, classic games. Yeah, classic games. Yeah, classic games. Yeah, classic games. Yeah, classic games.
Yeah, classic games. Yeah, classic games. Yeah, classic games. Yeah, classic
No, this, I like this for Hearthstone. Yeah, and everyone's like, what? Yeah, she kicked my ass in Hearthstone. Yeah, that one's up. Shin Godzilla. What? Have we mutated our koalas? Have we been irradiating them?
Hey guards,
yeah, remember this is the I think this one's all the Arashi guys again. Because yeah, they seem to be most of the Kirin ones. Oh no, it's just one of the Arashi guys. Okay. But yeah, they always seem to be the Kirin ones. And I don't know what's happening. I don't know whether Hideo Akehama is doing Evangelion, the fourth Evangelion movie, or the next Shin Godzilla. UFO Sword. UFO Sword. Nice. Yeah, I've been liking these ones, so... Yeah, I might look at my, we do have a few Asian groceries around here that might have these. It's usually, yeah, it's easier to get Southeast Asian stuff rather than, Japanese stuff, but, yeah, probably worth a look. Because there's places, there's like a really cheap, instant noodles you can get from Indonesia here called Indomie. So it usually ends up being about 50 cents a packet, and it comes with oil, chili sauce, and a couple other good things. Oh yeah, this has to be from a mobile game, surely. Yep. Which ads from the Middle East? Miss those ones. Were they in this, or is it just you referring to something else? Karadani peace. Karadani peace. What the fuck? What the fuck? No, what? Oh yeah, and there's a big Takeshi again. Cup noodle. What? And that's Kitano going back to his fucking comedy roots too. Because apparently he was, before he got big in directing and stuff, he did, Kansai Tsukomi, the comedy thing, you had the straight man and the comedy one just gets belted and stuff like that. Yeah, old Beat Takeshi's getting on a bit, that's for damn sure. That's for 80 something. Here we go. Steve-O. One's from Meditel with a Middle Eastern banking company. Okay, that's going on the list. TV. If they're anything like that Egyptian one we found, the panda cheese, get on that. Oh yeah, I have you on the list as well. Meditel. Yeah, I'll have a look, fun. Yeah, I'll bring up this fella as well. So one of the first costume kid shows I remember from my childhood is this guy. His name's Fat Cat. Not this Fat Cat, the other Fat Cat. And we always made fun of him because he wore, like, pants and no shirt. Or vice versa. And yeah, this is the anti-smoking ad. No, actually, no, this is a more... It's like mid-2000s, so it was a different one from the 80s. Lungs are
like sponges with millions of tiny air sacs for transferring oxygen. Every breath of tobacco smoke attacks them.
Yeah, this one's probably no worse, if anybody. Their lungs done lungs deteriorate. Now, there was one from the 80s specifically where they just say, this is how much tar builds up when you smoke, and they just like squeeze out this sponge that's meant to represent your lungs. Yeah, it's a little bit fucked up. I still smoked for like, you know, a good 5-6 years after that. Solution.
Now this bloke's got common sense. You can tell by his strides and shirt. The original Australian King G drill.
You can tell this guy's a rough and tumble man of character just from what he wears.
They don't try to look good, so they do. The original King G drill. Made for people who don't mess around.
I'll be waiting in the tent.
Get down to Retrovision now for the biggest range of electrical appliances.
Yeah, I think these guys are still sticking around.
We've a big range and great service. All
right, like this cordless
phone. A small $199.
Man, $200 for a cordless phone.
Panasonic 51-centimeter TV with remote.
$789. Yeah. Plus a small price on this high-quality VCR. $489.
Get down to the biggest retailer.
With small prices.
I think these guys are still kicking around, actually, Retrovision. The biggest retailer. Well, they might have been taken over by a bigger group.
You're looking sharp. You're looking good. You've come so far.
And we know how. Finally gets his face on in front of the camera.
The most of who you are.
Such a short.
It's what we've always done. To let.
Hang on, is this Fonzie singing this, old John Farnham? Wouldn't put it past him.
So many faces, it's plain to see. We give you all we have to give, for all a man can be. Where the race is run, you're the champion, Gillette.
The Gillette Atroplus system with the Lubra Smooth Strip.
All right, can reach the mute button on top of that one. And yeah, you don't see ads like that anymore. Just use our razors and you'll be a manly man. Because, yeah, the lines are kind of crossed on those ones, I guess. Alright, now we're up to the end. So this is the replacement for Funhouse tonight. This is apparently the Australian version of Double Dare. Never saw this on TV. Don't remember seeing it. Yeah, this would be 80s as fuck, because he's got the suit jacket with the sleeves rolled up.
Thank you, audience. Thanks for joining us today, Double D. Lots of fun, 30 minutes of fun and slime coming right your way. I'd like you to meet now the first team for today. On my right, they call themselves the Uncatchables.
Right. Yeah, I'm just wondering if this went through or not.
And Tom, Rosalind,
full episode with commercials intact. 89.
What one of your hobbies might be?
Didn't say if it was a pilot or anything.
I enjoy collecting butterflies.
Oh, that's lovely. What's the professional name for someone who collects butterflies? Do you know what that is?
No.
That's all right. Can you tell me what sort of butterflies are in your collection?
I collect jewelry, butterflies, and I've got brooches that come from Penang, and I've got necklaces and...
Oh, right, lots of different things in the shape of butterflies.
Yeah.
Good stuff. Yeah, so, like, a lot of girls collect ducks
and
things,
and
you collect butterflies.
Butterflies in Australia.
I was playing with Tom. Now, Tom, What about you? What do you collect?
Well, I collect toilet rolls.
Yeah.
Get out of here. No, seriously, you collect... Oh, what?
Yeah, I do.
New or used? What do you make out of these toilet rolls?
Well, when I had mice, I used to make mazes out of them, but now I just make castles and things out of them.
Yeah, that's what you do when your parents are cheap and won't buy you, you know, Castle Grayskull or anything like that.
That's what Tom amuses himself with. Welcome to the show, Tom. Challenges to the Uncatchables call themselves the Wildcats. Christian and Peter. Okay, Christian, talk to you first. What would you like to tell us about yourself?
Well, I really like Marilyn Monroe and... I like the 50s era in general.
Ooh, rockabilly before it was cool. That's different.
Why do you think you have a sort of passion for the 50s?
I don't know. I just think it's a wonderful era.
Do you think you were alive in the 50s and you've been reincarnated this time?
No.
You don't think you were Marilyn Monroe in your past life?
No.
All right. No, these kids are a lot animated than the average crowd for these.
Peter? Okay.
Except for this kid.
Welcome to the show. What are you going to do with your life, do you think?
Probably be a major cricket star.
Oh, yeah?
Play for Australian cricket.
Excellent. We're going to get a few more cricket stars.
Sports fans are therefore boring as fuck.
Pretty good.
Oh, pretty good? They've had a pretty good innings over in England recently.
Yeah.
How do you go in cricket?
This is the days when Australia used to win the Ashes.
What do you do? 24 not out.
Used to be actually a good cricket team.
Both.
Okay, Peter, welcome to the show. Now, our game works like this. Lots of questions here to be
answered. Yeah, they're probably all...
Give me an answer directly right
there. Actually, no, this lot would be older than me. The 89, I would have been 5.
Four times the original value, and you then have an option of either answering the question or taking...
Yeah, they might have grown up. Late 30s, early 40s.
Thank you. First question, to the Uncatchables. How many degrees has a right angle?
90.
That's right, easy. Geometry 1 to start.
Yep. Did they know the school?
Which Boom Crash opera single contains the line, "These here are crazy times"?
Dang.
Over to you, Wildcats, for 20 points now. Which Boom Crash opera single contains the line, "These here are crazy times"?
Get out of the house.
Oh no, Onion Skin. Onions. Do you know that one as well?
What?
Yeah, so just a minute.
I remember Boom Crash opera, but I can't remember what they specifically sang.
What did Debussy, Schubert, and Puccini write?
Puccini.
Over to you, Wildcat, for 20 points. Your option now. What did Debussy, Schubert, and Puccini write? Back to you, Uncatchables. Our first double dare or a physical challenge. Do you know what those three gentlemen wrote?
Physical challenge.
They wrote classical music. Classical music. That's all they wrote.
Oh. Mozart, just separate composers. I thought it was... Yeah, the question was weird on that, because it's like, did they all write the same thing together? But no.
Yeah, a bit of sound effects. That was very quick. Now, we're going to get you both mixed up in our little tutus. There's your little tutu over there, and Debbie has yours over there. Thanks, Rocket.
And look at the production value compared to, like, Funhouse.
As you can see, a whole bunch of... water balloons.
Yeah, this is called splash. You want to build like a whole obstacle course thing? Nah. Right, so get some balloons and some tutus, they'll be right.
Do you know what fifth position is in dancing?
No.
Well, that's kind of when your feet are like that, kind of go like that. Now, what you got to do with...
Is there anything like fifth base in baseball?
And your dance position, and we want you to splash.
I've seen the edited Wikipedia article on that one.
Splash dance. So if you can get all the balloons busted using your feet in 15 seconds, those points are yours. Okie dokie, have some fun with this one. On your marks, get set, go!
Oh my god. Yeah, these kids' knees would be fucked by now. No helmets or anything. Yep.
Wildcats pick those points. Okie dokie. She's laughing a lot. She's all right. She's all right. Those little balloons running away from their feet. So Wildcats in control. You're on Wildcats. You get the 40 points. Phil just hit them with 40. There we go. All right. What were the first names of the comedy duo Laurel and Hardy?
Stan and Oliver.
Stan and Oliver.
They get multiple choice on this one. Ivan and Olga. Yeah, right. Yeah, I have a feeling this did not get on TV. This has like a pilot sort of feel to it.
What were the first names of the comedy duo Laurel and Hardy? Was it Stan and Oliver, Sam and Orville, or Ivan and Olga?
Stan and Oliver?
Yes, that's right. Well done, Rosalind. Now you're on 70. Post that question. That's what I do. I put them away once we've asked them. What is Australia's richest annual horse race?
Happening in Melbourne Cup, surely.
That's right. That's right.
Dead on. I remember that for school, actually.
Very recently.
It was usually like a Friday or a public holiday. It was usually... I just remember a couple of classes where we'd actually stop and listen to the Melbourne Cup race.
That's where we mine gold, Western Australia. Over that way, not to worry. Control.
Yeah, no, that one's tricky.
For that, but you're in control. This question's worth 10 points. What was the final fate of the three ships, the William Gustloff, the Andrea Doria, and the Titanic? Peter, yes, sir. What is it?
And they all sank.
Yeah, they all sank. Yes, I think the Titanic.
Titanic's a giveaway. Yeah.
Don't have to put your hand up. You just confer. Kristen, here we go. What is the longest stretch of railway line in the world? Is it the Trans-Siberian, the Canadian Pacific, or the Southern Aurora?
Well, I'd say Trans-Siberian.
To you, Wildcats.
The Southern Aurora.
That's probably one of the longest. Southern Aurora is a train line here in Australia. It runs from Sydney to Melbourne. No, the Trans-Siberian is the longest railway.
Yeah, where does that run? That'd have to be through Europe, surely.
Railway fanatics, if the Southern Aurora isn't the longest in Australia, what's the one that runs from Sydney to Perth? Indian Pacific, that's the longest.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you. Just so, don't touch your phones. We got it right.
They must have had the GANs set up by here either. Because there's one that goes from South Australia, Adelaide, to Darwin and Northern Territory through Alice Springs. So, straight through the middle vertically in Australia.
Right. Rolling stone gathers no moss, which is a little old saying. 70 playing 80, it's close. What does a flautist do for a living?
That's flute.
Thunder.
They're
over to you, Uncatchables, for 20 points now. What does a flautist? What does a flautist do for a living?
Double
deck. Back to you, Wildcats, for 40 points of physical challenge. What are you going to do?
Okay, I guess you get more points if you get that.
Flautist plays the flute. There, simply enough, plays the flute. Doesn't flout anything. Yeah. Let's step out this way, Wildcats. This physical challenge is called Ring, Ring, Ring on the Phone. And this is that's right, the phone never stops ringing because you'll both be wearing our special telephone Double Dare designer hats. Here they go.
Oh my God.
What teams have to do in this one is, as you
can see, the first one stops their knees, this one stops their neck.
Studio audience, don't forget you. They both have our little Double Dare hats on. They
also, I remember rotary phones, they're heavy as shit. At least bloody 2 kilos.
Face your partner, there's your line right there. And there's your line. Now, all you've got to do for me is you've got to get one ring on your partner's telephone. That's why it's called Ring, Ring, Ring on the Phone. You've got lots of rings there.
Oh, so that's terrible. That's a terrible dad joke. Ring, ring, ring.
This for me. Over there like that. It's fine, or just on the top. There you go. 20 seconds on the clock and 40 points if you can do it. On your marks, get set, go. Here we go.
And John gave us a plug too. Thank you, John. Bring up that list.
Ah, they're crashing in the middle. Now keep going. A bit tricky. Well, I caught one anyway. So the points go across to the Uncatchable. See you, Rocket.
Those rings don't even look like they're big enough to actually get around the phone.
They're on 120. And that sound means conveniently the end of round one. As I said, Uncatchables are on 120. But the Wildcats, prove that the Uncatchables are in fact catchables. That's why they call themselves the Wildcats. Round two, just around the corner. Back soon.
The Brown Street Boys go to...
Oh, we get some 80s ads. Okay.
And will Tam pay for her silence?
I can't help you if you refuse to speak to me.
I want to see Tam.
The Henderson Kids 2. Tonight, 7 o'clock.
Don't remember that show. Yeah, I should bring that up. There was a lot of certain shows would only be produced in certain states in Australia. So if you're in one state, there was a good chance you wouldn't see a specific, like, I grew up in Queensland and there were a lot of shows that were specifically produced in Melbourne, Victoria, and like, yeah, we didn't see a lot of those till after the fact. But yeah, it's good they brought back SodaStream. Yeah, good way to recycle bottles and shit. Yeah, I remember that one. And like the little flaps on the bottom for the person who got it first. If your numbers match, be the first to slam down your hand. Yeah, need to find. I'd have to sift through, and find like specific Australian board game ads.
Hands down from Milton Bradley.
In the quest for long life, no ordinary carbon battery lasts like Duracell.
Oh, yeah, this is kind of actually surprisingly well shot for just like a little, you know, production effects
Duracell
ad.
Ordinary carbon battery looks like it's
different.
All lasts like it.
Huh.
What do you want?
What do you think?
What you want?
Ooh.
I want latest games anywhere. What do you want?
I want the sounds that curl my hair.
Actually, no, I think we have seen this one.
7800s everywhere.
Oh, I thought this was for the NES. No, this is the Atari 7800, apparently. Okay. Got something in my mess, you fatty. You're. And yeah, Toy World.
One
BW.
Of the coolest shops around for young people has to be Ollion Skateboards in Belconnen, the only specialist skateboard shop in Canberra. When you choose from the mega range of skateboards,
okay.
Trucks, wheels, and accessories, their skilled staff will assemble your board free of charge. Plus, they've got all the best brands of protective gear, and clothing and shoes are available, not only for
yeah,
skaters,
can't beat the
also for those who just want to look great. So
hurry
on to Ollion Skateboards, Walter Street, Belconnen. Lay-by and gift vouchers available.
Yeah, so that's I actually had to pull some people up on it. People presume that Sydney is the capital of Australia. It's actually Canberra. So there's like a very small state in New South Wales called the ACT. That's yeah, where all the politicians meet.
We've seen this one, and it's a fun one.
And that's our capital.
The teams have each been given a box of tissues. What they have to do, while one partner holds the tissue box pretty firm, the other partner has to pull out the tissues one at a time. So no clump handfuls, but pull them out one at a time as quick as you can.
Are they getting practice for teenage life when they start reading picture magazine?
All right. 40 points up for grabs in control of round two. On your marks, get set, go!
Not practice of puberty.
He's doing the old supporting against the hip trick.
We're probably going to need another box. Yeah, off night. That's a quick slide, isn't it?
I think it's a big box of tissues. It's 500 double sheet, double ply tissues.
It's pretty fucking wasteful, though.
Get bad colds, as opposed to when you just get the sniffles. Keep it going, keep it cooking, keep it there.
Oh, no, it's just keep going until you empty the box, rather.
Right. Take it out, all right. All right. Alright, there we go. Yes, just clear that bit of dust in those tissues. There you are. You're uncatchable. Sorry, I was looking the wrong way. Uncatchables, you're on 160 for 20 points now. The handset of what modern device has an earpiece, a mouthpiece, and a diaphragm?
Oh.
Over to you, Wildcats, for 40 points now. Which handset?
Oh, yeah, it's back when analog.
Has an earpiece, mouthpiece,
yeah, because the diaphragm would be what you'd. Would pick up the sound.
Back
yeah.
To you, uncatchables for 80 points or a physical challenge. What's on your mind?
Physical challenge.
Well, guess what? We just had one on the show. Telephone. Handset has an earpiece, mouthpiece.
Good old fucking analog telephones. Wow.
Uncatchables. Oh, I like this one.
And you're doing cute stuff when you're not on camera, Cat.
Get in here. I need to know who is the best.
Oh, that's adorable.
Oh, look. Yes, she does.
He just woke up from sleep and he's doing the whole brush himself with the paw. You're so cute, Cat. Know that? Which Louise will just tighten on you. Just don't push on my mouse. Louise, please. Hang on, sorry, what? What just happened then? Which Louise will just tighten on you. Now we want Louise, please. Now, could you please sit down for us? Okay. That's right. Good man. Now, I gotta keep an eye on Louise, I think. She might be going on a list at some point. Water and our nice mop here. What you gotta do is bring your mop over the stage and wring it. And wring it into the cup. All you've got to do is get the water past the pink line. In 20 seconds, the 80 points are yours. So, on your marks, get set, go! All right. Oh, she's got... Oh, my God. Do it slowly.
Yeah, I have a feeling this is why the show didn't go through. Yeah, polished floor with sneakers. It's no wonder you got no bloody traction. Yeah, someone must have fucking stove their head in or something. Tripping over. Because, yeah, don't remember seeing... Yeah, like, we didn't see any of these sort of shows until probably Amazing, I guess. That's the one I grew up with. And that wasn't until, you know, like, mid-90s, early mid-90s. War and Peace, Hamlet. Damn. Yeah.
Over to you for Wildcats for 40 points. The Russian writer Leo Tolstoy, did he write Tale of Two Cities, War and Peace, or Hamlet?
No, War and Peace, yeah.
Double
Tale of Two Cities was Dickens. Not going to take a shot at
Uncatchables to you for 80 points. Or another physical challenge. What are you going to do?
Physical challenge.
He wrote War and Peace, and it's a big book. Spend your Christmas holidays reading it.
Yeah. He's not fucking wrong.
Let's go, Uncatchables.
What do they say, like, the standard edition of War and Peace is? Like, at least 1,000 pages? Something ridiculous?
One of you has to get dressed as an explorer, and one of you has to be our mummy. Who would like to do which? You'll be the mummy.
Yes,
we step over there, and now we're going to get you dressed as our explorer. So, in very Indiana Jones style, we're going to give you a pack, a pair of goggles, and a hat, make you look like a bit of an explorer. And also, a bandage. Now, this is what this physical challenge is all about. This bandage here, are you right? Now, I'll explain the rules to you. Here's your bandage.
Leave besides the hat.
Then you can grab this in and cross your hands. Cross your arms like a mummy. You've ever seen a mummy? That's it. Then using this bandage, I need you to cover your partner from head to foot with the bandage. There you go. You've got 20 seconds to do it in. And I'll judge it to see if you've actually got enough of her cover to get the points. On your marks, get set for 80 points. Go!
It slips straight on the floor. Yep. Yo, don't like the face. Let's cover that up straight away.
So just stand still.
They only get 20 seconds to do it on the slippery ass floor, too. Okay. Yeah, spin around. There you go.
Well, I think maybe a third, but there's a lot of red still there. So those points go across to the Wildcats.
Damn. No, that one's a bit unfair.
Wildcats, you're on 150. Hey, diddle diddle, the cat and the...
Biddle.
Biddle.
That's all right. You're right. They shouted out. It's 170. We're out of time. That's it. That's the end of round two. So on 240 points, our winners today are the Uncatchables. Step over
here, oh, that camera work, though. That was a terrible cut. Yeah, camera two's not on his game.
You're fine. You two hang there. We have to thank the Wildcats now for coming in and being great challengers in today's game.
Oh, they still won. Okay.
Christian Peter played very well. Thanks for coming on the show. And I think Simon's got a whole lot of prizes for you.
You'd be right, Jerry. You'll both receive a Double Dare prize pack, which includes a selection of books from Apple, including the paper,
Babysitter's Club,
and car parts, the microcars with the multi-purpose accessories from NASTA. And if you don't
have
an unladen swallow, there's a good chance you'll have to perform a physical
challenge. So it's what, a car part with a Matchbox car on it? Okay.
Thanks, Wildcats. That's right.
That saves them not too bad for a consolation prize if they're both getting it.
Can't keep Rosalind down, she's jumping all over the stage, same with Tom. The Aussie, of course, just around the corner where they can get to strut their stuff back soon.
And yeah, no, I'm actually more intrigued to see the ads for this one.
Sunday afternoon, live, Australia's Iron Men are back for round two of the Uncle Toby Super Series, The Battle of Bondi.
3 hours of action featuring Australia's most famous Iron Man. The War on Water, live on 10 Sports Action.
Oh, yeah, this was the alternate version of Trouble, wasn't it? Oh, they still got Trouble, though. Yeah, we had Pop-O-Matic Trouble. Hell yeah. And it wasn't really... Yeah, the Pop-O-Matic thing was the appeal of it, wasn't it? Oh, wow. Yeah, I remember these. With their new album, Born to Rock. The actual album. Yep, yep. Alvin and the Chipmunks sing all your favorite hits. I can't remember who animated the Chipmunks. It's got a bit of a Don Bluth vibe, didn't it?
Plus, we'll include this giant poster free. The Chipmunks and the Chipettes. Born to Rock. Plus the free giant poster. In stores now.
Thank God I remember this ad. What was this for?
The best way to pull a funny face is out of its wrapper.
That's right, it was little ice blocks. Oh my.
Funny face, extra big, extra delicious, and refreshing ice blocks.
No, I get a bit freaked out seeing children bite into like funny solid blocks of ice because I got cavities and stuff. I have very sensitive teeth. I think we're running out of this. Yeah, plug it in the coat.
Now pay attention. This is the new sports auto chassis you've been waiting for. V4 engine, 3-speed airbox, companion steering, pop-up headlights.
And 4-wheel independent suspension.
Will you ever grow up?
Ooh, James Bond's
pose. Be careful. It wasn't designed for quite that purpose. Now listen, this is your seaplane. Note the landing gear.
Oh, this is for the Meccano. No, not Meccano.
I never joke about Lego Technic.
Lego Technic. That's the one. Fantastic. Yeah. Couldn't remember if it was Lego affiliated or not.
Party partners, this here is Tom, and this here is Rosalind. Here we are with the Uncatchables. Their first obstacle is flying high.
Okay, they do an obstacle. Oh, well, not a course, just more balloons. Balloons are cheap.
People may say the way, double dare, you need bats in your belfry. Not so, because from hats in the belfry, you both wear home one of these novelty hats.
Oh, what?
Uncatchables in our hamster wheel. Run around like a little hamster. The lights
are on. Oh, you do the obstacle, you win the prize. Okay.
Grab the flag and you've grabbed this prize.
From Ventura, you'll receive a noisy sound effect novelty. Either a burping ball, a laughing ball, excuse me, or a screaming ball. Yours from Ventura.
No fart balls.
Did you say excuse me, okay. Simon?
I did, Jerry.
Number 3, our tank. Run up the stairs, take a big jump off the end. This is the fast part of the show. Yep, the moving part. Here's a fluoro flag. Give it to your partner, and you've both won this prize.
Bon Voyage. No, you're not going anywhere. That's what you'll both win. The around-the-world travel game, Bon Voyage. Have a nice trip.
Oh, that looks awful. Look at all the text on that. My kid's going to pay attention to that shit.
Looks like this. Big pieces of toast over here.
Okay, there's some production value.
Oh, there it is. It's Gunge flag. Pick it up, and you've both got this prize.
Yeah, get that gun flag.
Let us rejoice, because you'll both win an Australian flag. This knitted light polyester flag comes to you from Carol and Richardson.
Really?
Number 5 is through the ringer.
So prize is a shit.
And we want you to go through the ringer and look at what Justine's created today. Beautiful mermaid, like in Splash. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle from Bobber. Here we are, fluoro flag. Give it to your partner, and this prize is yours.
You'll both be able to make your choice of t-shirts, sweatshirts, shearers and convict shirts, jackets, bags, umbrellas and braces.
Shearers and convict shirts. Okay.
Number 6, our pipeline. In our pipeline, like a bunch of little, well, what travels in a pipeline? What travels? Oh, there they are. The rats, whatever they are. Here, pass this flag on your partner, and I think Simon's got another prize for you.
You'd be right. This is just an example of a selection of some of the things you might wish to purchase with a gift voucher. You'll be the comic kingdom.
Okay, okay.
Here are beautiful chocolates, peppermint, lemon flavored.
Yeah, show your kids. I saw Batman the Killing Joke in there.
Is the flag number 7, and when you've got it, you've got this delicious prize.
I suppose they're teenagers. It was a very just dark implications. The fucking Killing Joke. Could be worse. Could be Lost Girls or something like that.
Been mountaineering?
Yes,
sort of. Well, that's exactly what you've got to do in this one. Like a little mountain goat or a mountaineer yourself, you've got to climb up to the end of our rope.
More balloons.
Reach out, yep. And I'll just bring this flag.
This is how you do an obstacle course in Australia without spending any money.
Less than 60 seconds, this prize is yours.
It's a Nintendo Entertainment System.
Ah, that's more like it.
This set includes control deck, two game controllers, and comes to you from Mattel.
Oh, not even the fancy one. Not even, not even the big pack with the zapper and Rob the Robot.
Go faster. You feeling terrible. Confident?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, untouchables. Good. Uncatchables. Good luck with this. On your
untouchables.
Mark. Get set. Go.
Yeah, I'm sure as hell glad you're not touching those kids, mate.
Into the hamster wheel.
Yep, hamster wheel. Holy fuck, that'd be heavy.
Two, three, four, five, six. There it goes. No, no, you missed it. You missed it. You got
hey, grab
it.
Grab the flag. Holy fuck, that's a good jump. Get in the sandwich. Yeah. Don't even have to jump in the jam. Okay. And what's... Oh, someone actually took the time to put that together. And it just gets destroyed by some child. That'd be right. Come on, get that Nintendo! Get it! Yeah!
Alright, well done. Take a look at all your prizes.
You've won a novelty hat from Hats in the
Bell. Yeah, alright, so. Alright, no, all of them together is actually a little bit fairer. The flag you could do without in the board game. Oh, gift voucher for the Comic Kingdom. Okay, okay. Didn't say how much either.
So your confidence was well worth it.
Yeah.
You had a good time?
Yeah.
Okay, thanks, Tom. Thanks, Rosalind. We're out of time. And remember, in Double Dead, life is either a daring adventure
or nothing. Yeah, yeah. I have a feeling this isn't going right, because the... Yeah, the host isn't engaging. Very... Oh, now they've got helmets on, I've just realised. Okay. Yeah, I'll see if we can find some more of this, but I don't get your hopes up. Probably have to go back to fun. Yeah, we'll find like an alternative to Funhouse. Sort of have to wean ourselves, run our episodes for that. But that's it for this week, guys. Yeah, thank you, Funk, for coming along. Thank you, TB, for coming along, and Biddies and the like. Glad your thesis went well. And yeah, all the fucking Vine Tools and Jammer I've been watching. But yeah, we'll leave it there. I'll put this on YouTube and we'll catch you guys